We refuse to allow a police officer to choke a white man and get immediately fired for it, whereas another police officer chokes a black man to death and still has a job and is not indicted for further prosecution.
Right.
Yeah. So enough is enough.
Yeah.
Enough is enough.
Right.
May our voices be heard. May we be here in unity and in solidarity with what's happening here and all across the nation.
And the world.
And the world.
Yeah.
And oppression today. We have our demands and we demand it now.
Thank you.
Okay, bye.
Yeah.
Please leave me alone. I think the last time. Please leave me alone. meeting with the Obama administration, Department of Justice, the sheriff of the city, county of San Francisco. And we're talking about how we can make community policing more than just rhetoric. And it happened to me that when I got back on the plane, then I ended up sitting next to the mother of Oscar Grant. We had never met before, but we clicked immediately. And it's the duration of a very delayed flight allowed us to thoroughly exchange notes and us to be more sensitive and committed that it's time that in the United States that we make us a colorblind society.
We're not colorblind society. We will never be colorblind. We will never be colorblind.
Be respectful of all people, and that we hold law enforcement accountable.
You project this, sir. This is how you project this, sir. You see this photo. This is how you project this, sir. You beat us. This is how you project this, sir. You kill us. You kill my mother, my brother, my sister, my father.
The reason why we can't stay on the steps is because we don't have a permit. So we are going to carry on right here.
What's the permit?
Carry on.
You don't allow them to protect us. Can't we stay on the side? You don't allow them to protect us.
Hey, Johnny, are police in his car?
I know. I have two poets that are going to speak right now. We have two poets. Before we start, we're not going to do a dying. We got too much cars. We're going to have Mama T. Again, this is a peaceful, non-violent demonstration. I have two poets. We need space.
Go, Mama T.
And we have Mama T from City College.
Go, Mama T.
We have school in the same institution as Alex Nieto. She is an active member.
We need some peace. We need prayer. And so I'm going to start out with a spiritual. I'm going to start out with a spiritual.
Go ahead, Mama. Pray on you just a little while longer. Pray on just a little while longer. Oh, pray on.
Punched a hole in it and traced it on his mouth.
Robin.
Thank you.
sure that we keep this momentum going, that we keep it strong, we keep it consistent. And on Monday, December 15th, at Mission High School at 4 p.m. in the auditorium, we have Michael Brown's father coming to speak. The Black Student Union of Mission High School decided that they wanted to step up. They wanted to be part of this movement, so I hope that each and every one of you will come out Monday, 4 p.m., and we'd love to see you all. I want to thank you guys all again for coming out and demonstrating peacefully. And next up we have Katie Williams, whose brother, his sister.
Hi everyone, I'm the sister of O'Shea Evans that was murdered by San Francisco Police Officer David Goff on October 7th of this year. Yes, right in your backyard if you want to know about it. We didn't even know about it. My mother, they pronounced him dead at 9:32 p.m. that night, and we didn't get a call until 2:07 in the morning. Not from the police station, but from the coroner's office. Tell my mother while she's laying in her bed that her son has been murdered by San Francisco police. I got that call about 2:10 from my mother crying, saying, Kadeem, they kill us in, they kill us in, they kill us in. San Francisco police officer kill us in. You don't know what it's like to hear that coming from your mother, that your brother was killed, and your mother is just crying, and you don't know what to do. I don't know how I got to her house. Praying, like, please, God, get me over there. I didn't drive that car. God took me over there that night because I couldn't drive. I was by myself. My sister had a panic attack. She had to call the ambulance to get her. So I drove over there. My mother was in the street crying, holding her stomach. And they killed my baby. When we got over here to San Francisco, they said to the General Hospital, they said that the body was gone. They waited for us. How could you have waited for us? We got there around 3-something. How could you have waited for us? And no one called us. The only person called us was the coroner. Why is the coroner calling us? And then another thing, the town hall meeting. We weren't notified of the town hall meeting. If it wasn't for Channel 7 News, we'd have never knew about it. They lied, and they continued to lie on my brother. He was sitting in his car. He was just sitting there, and police officers, his friends were committing a crime. They walked up to him, and he pulled an unloaded gun on him. Come on. Unloaded gun? Anyone that knows my brother knows that. He's not going to pull a gun on a police officer. 2 weeks before that, he was stopped in Oakland for driving on a suspended license. When my mother went to go get him, the officer said, oh, your son was well-behaved, he didn't give me any problems, da-da-da. And then 2 weeks later, officer in San Francisco killed him, saying that he pulled an unloaded gun. People don't believe the hype. Don't believe what these people say on the news. They're all lies. They lie on our family. They write up this phony story and put it out there. Say, oh, say this. Let's say this. He gave my mother so many promises at the town hall meeting. It was like, oh, you're going to be able to clean your car up. We're going to get it back to you. And da-da-da-da. Until now, we haven't heard from that man. We don't even know what kind of investigation they're doing. Personally, I don't believe in that investigation. Because how does the police investigate the police? How does that work? His trainer came out and spoke the first visual we had at 850 Bryant. He said that O'Shea had hurt his head, you know, training, and he was out for a month. And that same day when he got killed, he went there and said, you know what, I'm ready, I'm coming back. But he never made only to know that he was saying his goodbye to his trainer, you know, that his life would be taken by Officer David Goff. Officer David Goff. Officer David Goff. You know what it's like to hear your mother crying every day saying, my baby won't come home. He's not coming home. If O'Shea was here, he would have helped me with this because they live together. You know what? Now that my heart is hurting. My stomach hurts. You know, this is the worst feeling. I wouldn't wish this. I would wish this on David Goff. I would wish this on him. But I wouldn't wish this on anyone else. But thank you guys for all your support, and, you know, I don't know how to keep calm in this. I don't know how to keep calm, because until I get justice, they're not going to get any peace out of me. So I don't know how to keep calm. Until I get justice, there will be no peace. Until I get justice, there will be no peace.
quiet day, and we all here. But I want everybody to just look around at each other and be so grateful in the power to the people right now. This is the next generation. This is what we got to do to change the world right here, right now. You know what I'm saying? So I'm about to do this poll, and it's directed right at the police state, and it's called Cops Keep Firing. So you can do the hook if you want to with me, and I'm going to use these brothers and these sisters who've been killed right here while I go. And the hook is basically, cops keep firing in our environment. Cops keep firing in our environment. Say it as loud as you can and let these police hear, you know what I'm saying? But I'm about to do it right now. What happened to freeze and put your hands up high? A simple traffic stop with these pigs, a brother might die. I asked why we let it slide and never bust back. But you only comfortable shooting a gun if your target is black. But anyway, this new Jim Crow breed just kill a cop. The real terrorists and agitators patrolling our block. Man, my hands on the steering wheel, why your hands on your Glock? I was just reaching my insurance in the Reggie out the glove box. In high school, they used to be punks. They insecure little chumps. So they get a job at the port so they can duck. 50 shots in the brown and a black. A coward only shoots you in the back. Killing unarmed citizens. What's up with that? Oh, Rootsy ass, I thought it was a taser ass pig, but take the custody, the only way that Beverly will live. 10,000 young people killed by the police. From Kenneth Hardy and HP, the Kamani Grand, the East has got a seat. Cops keep firing in my environment. 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 Cops keep firing. Rest in peace, Dr. Grant. Rest in peace, Sean Bell. Rest in peace, Rakia Boyd. Come on, come on. This so-called war on drugs and mass incarceration. Read the label. Well, I got it right here. Hold on. That's the hook, y'all. Hold on real quick. The so-called war on drugs and mass incarceration. Prison labor, death penalty, and LWOP. Got them racially profiling because they think we are wildin'. What you pull me over for, son? Your descriptions, I fit none. I ain't the one like Ice Cube, so don't come at me rude. You give respect to give respect, young pig. I'm from the old school. But I ain't no fool, I keep my hands where you can see him. He said, I'll chew you if you move. I took his word, I believe him. They got the upper hand now, but hopefully not for long. That's intentions and purpose behind me making this song. We gotta fight for something, or die for nothing at all. We gotta stand for something, or what my people will call. Let's release ourselves, make our own justice system. Raise a nation of lawyers and protect all the failed missions. When you get out of prison, come home and protect your hood. By any means necessary, you protect our hood. Make sure it's good. Come on, y'all. Cops keep firing in my environment. 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 Come on. Last vote, y'all. How y'all feeling? Look at suspicious behavior or appearance. Is that your racist excuse for your stopping French pump? We ain't trying to hear it. Militarized occupation along with racist legislation gives impunity for killers with a badge, no hesitation. Black communities was organized for our own self-defense. No more passive resistance. You want to preserve our existence? I'm taking our human rights violations to the United Nations. I'm bringing up criminal charges for this police lawlessness. My motto, praise the gods, but pass me the ammunition. I'm willing to die for my people. It's time you make that decision. If you're scared of a hurt, then take your ass to church. Because if you stand for these pigs, you can die when you stand in the dirt. Every 36 hours, a brother's killed by the pigs. This is a nationwide call to protect that kid. Whether it's an eye for an eye or a tooth for a tooth, let's make the police think twice before they kill me and you. Stand up for the hood, fools. And I got love for everybody here, but as of now, the people of color are suffering worse statistically than they were during the civil rights era. This is a new civil rights. Everything you see manifested before you is the result of a dream. Evil is by design. I'm half Native American. Hundreds of millions of Native Americans and blacks have been killed in the history of this government. It is designed by evil, and to this day, we are still suffering. The 13th Amendment stated that all slaves were to be free. But there was a clause that said if they commit any crime, they will go right back into slavery. Crimes included stepping on a white person's shadow or looking at a white woman. From the beginning, we have been the criminals, and we have actually been the victims. We haven't done anything but get abused and accused. Oh, I rhymed right there. I'm happy to see everybody here and the beautiful people. We all need to come together and help change the disparity economically, politically, and legally for the people of color. This is still happening today. Love, peace, and happiness, international, like the rain from clouds, everything that falls will find its place. Thank you very much.
Because justice is not fast, and justice is not free. But you have to decide if you're going to be a bystander and stand by, or you're going to be an upstander and stand up for your rights. Power to the people! 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 Thank you.
Don't shoot!
Hands up!
Don't shoot!
Hands up!
Don't shoot!
To the guy!